Thank you, Madam Chair, and thanks for leading off and starting that discussion, because I find this whole thing like head scratching in so many different ways. I mean, the notion that, first of all, from the Northwest perspective, what has driven affordable electricity has driven our economy over and over again. So I'm very interested in affordable electricity, bottom line. So the notion that someone would supplant the market of delivering that affordable electricity on the next most available unit of cost-effective energy and supplant it with an order that would say buy something more expensive is disrupting the whole market. So I don't know why we would go back to that. I mean, is the administration for re-regulating electricity, is that what that position is? Because I don't get it. The Power Act definitely is there for shortage and shortage only, which you've all just said is not there. And the Defense Act says the same, shortage, which is not there. So the notion that we would be, you know, we had this debate in committee once where we were empathetic on our side to the fact that, okay, first of all, we created this big policy here in the United States on production, natural gas. We've claimed it as a big success, and then it did compete with sources of more expensive energy. I think we voted to say that some of those Midwest coal plants, facilities that were getting coal, that were getting competed with on rail for supply, we were a little more empathetic. But that's a different, story than just out and out charging consumers more just because we want to preference one over the other. So I just find this whole thing almost mind-boggling in the policy element that somebody would be throwing down on a FERC that is basically operating to give us just and reasonable lowest cost electricity, at least in those organized markets. So Commissioner Powelson used to regulate rates for consumers, and last year the PJM market monitor said the DOE's proposal for FERC would raise the wholesale rate by 84%, so you rejected that proposal. Do you think this latest proposal is any different?
I haven't looked at the analytics. I know that the market monitor has been very vigilant in looking at this and outreaching to state commissions and consumer advocates, and I've also met with those groups. I do think, Senator, it's critically important to your point. I mean, here we are today in PJM. In 2008, we were in a $14 gas market, and here we are today in a $2 in, you know, Henry Hub, or we'll call it Pennsylvania Lighty Hub, in a 226 market with ample supply, and wholesale power prices have dropped 56%. In fact, in my home state, retail customers are paying less for power today prior to restructuring. I mean, that's a, and customers in Pennsylvania and your home state, I follow what the commission approved with Microsoft looking for a sustainable energy product. The market will deliver those outcomes, and I think it's critically important for us. And again, I commend our chairman and my colleagues working in a bipartisan manner. Always remain diligent on reliability, look at the issue of resiliency, but the technology landscape, as I said in my testimony, has changed to just things we couldn't fathom 10 years ago. It's been a great thing for organized markets. We've learned a lot of lessons. As you know, there was a company in Houston that bastardized that construct. I didn't want to go there. But today, it has been a phenomenal success story. In fact, I will say this to you in a recent presentation. The restructuring of these markets is arguably one of the largest wealth transfers to take place in our nation's history. And I think it's something that we should not retreat on.
Well, I appreciate you mentioning that situation, because I do think in the time of Enron, people tried to get the FERC to use all sorts of other standards by which to look at that problem. And I think that the FERC realized that that was, that your just and power, just and reasonable rate clause was the focus and should always be the focus of FERC. So I don't even agree on the security side. I'm very well aware where our cybersecurity attacks are coming from. And some of these have been into our plant operating systems. And so it doesn't matter what the plant operating source is. The issue is that cybersecurity could disrupt any type. So our goal here is to try to build better resiliency and backups and information into the system so that we can better track that kind of attack no matter what the source is. So I don't even agree that this is an issue about that somehow these other sources could be more reliable or secure. I don't even agree with that. So anyway, we hope the commission will keep playing this role. You know, this we're reaping the benefits of what we all pushed here, which was to have more natural gas, and now it's here. And so I think we have to let the market continue to play its role.